I'm just giving my son a little bit of a yogurt peanut butter snack. Anyway, it is currently 9 o'clock. He woke up around 6:30, and he's probably gonna go down here for a nap very soon. So I'm just giving him kind of like a mid-morning snack because we went for a long walk. And today is gonna be a fun day. We have a little Easter activity that we're going to, a little event, and I'm excited because we're all going to be going today, the whole family, and I have some fun little Easter outfits that I want to share with you guys, some little ideas. It's kind of cloudy today, so unfortunately I won't be wearing, like, I don't know. I was hoping of wearing like one of the outfits that I'm gonna share with you, but it's a little bit like cloudy today and like in the 60s. I'll be sharing some of my favorite items today, some makeup, some fashion, because I think you guys have requested that. So it's gonna be a little combination of day in the life plus just, you know, some girly stuff in there. You like that? Making him a bottle for nap time. We ran out of our whole milk, so gotta use this 2%. And I just boil some water, put in about an ounce or two of hot water, and then it's time for me to go shower and get ready. I'm gonna share with you guys some of my current makeup favorites. These are all things that you can find. Most of them, I would say, most of them you could find online. A lot of them are going to be drugstore products. I'm kind of leaning more towards the drugstore products right now just because I feel like they work just as great as some of the higher end stuff. What I've lately been doing is I've just been putting foundation on, no setting powder, because I am noticing as I'm getting older that my skin is not as oily as it used to be. And in fact, what I've been doing, and I don't know if this is good or bad for you, but this is the Era Organics Super Balm, and I actually purchased this because my son, when he was a newborn, suffered with cradle cap, and I just did a bunch of research online about what to use that was like organic, fragrance free. This has got like beeswax, cocoa butter. I don't know if this is necessarily good or bad just based on the ingredients, but I've been using it a bunch and I haven't noticed any breakout or anything. And I just apply this like around my scalp area that tends to get really, really dry, around my nose. And then I have like this dry patch here on my chin. So I've been applying some there. And so far I've really been liking it. For foundation, I'm obsessed with this. This is like my everyday go-to foundation. This is the L'Oreal True Match Super Blendable Foundation. I'm in the shade W4. And this is like full coverage, but not super full coverage that you feel like you're feeling cakey. Just a really nice, wearable, everyday foundation. I really, really love how they have so many different shades to choose from. And I just apply it with this brush. This is the Eco Tools foundation brush and I just bring it down on my chin, on my neck, and love it. Just so easy. It blends out so fast and I don't feel like it wears off throughout the day. I feel like it lasts pretty well and I just am super in love with this one. For concealer, what I have been wearing, now I used to not, like I wasn't super into this foundation, concealer when I first bought it, but I really, really like it now because I feel like the staying power is amazing. Some days I set it, other days I don't, and both times it looks phenomenal. It doesn't crease, it lasts throughout the day. Great coverage if you're looking to cover up your dark under eyes. It just gives you a really nice kind of like smooth under eye area. And they have so many different shades to choose from. So if you wanted to go a little bit lighter, you can, to kind of brighten up your under eye. I've been just sticking with sort of like one or two shades lighter than my actual like foundation shade because I don't want it to be too bright under my eye. But this is the Huda Beauty Faux Filter Luminous Matte Liquid Concealer. I'm in the shade Cookie Dough, that's 44.3N. And like I mentioned, they've got so many different shades to choose from. It's just got like this doe foot applicator. The one thing that I don't like about this is that it does get everywhere. Like it is everywhere on this bottle. And I don't know if that's a flaw of the packaging or if that's just me not doing a good job at taking care of this, but love it. Can't complain. Does the job. I just blend this with my beauty sponge. For my eyebrows, I have been just keeping it so basic, you guys. I ran out of my Benefit brow pencil, so I haven't had the time or really just like the energy to go and purchase a $26 eyebrow pencil when I just don't really go anywhere these days. I'm home all the time. So I've just been setting my brows. I haven't been filling them in or anything. And I've been using the NYX, the brow glue in dark brown. And I actually don't miss filling in my brows. That's one less step. And as you know, being a mom, you have a limited time in the morning to get ready. So this is literally glue and hold my brows in place. They're not going anywhere. So cheap, but this stuff lasts. Go get your hands on this because you don't need a high-end brow gel. This will do it. I have been really liking, and I think you guys may have seen me talk about this. I'm like obsessed with them. They are, I have a full container of them. They are the Sephora Collection lip stains, liquid lipsticks. And I'm going to wear this shade here. It's the shade 83. And these are awesome for such an affordable price. It's like, they have so many different shades. They have so many different colors. It lasts. Doesn't dry out my lips. Doesn't feel sticky, tacky. I do like to put some gloss on the top. This is by Rimmel. It's called Oh My Gloss. And I have another shade of this as well. I forget the shade of this. I'll try and leave links to this one, but it's just like a pretty kind of lavender shade. And I just do a little bit to get a little bit of gloss going because I'm obsessed with gloss. Even if I'm at the house, this is what I do just to make myself feel a little bit better because, you know, I'm home a lot. I'm taking care of my son. I'm working. Not a lot of days do I get to go out and like do the full glam. So I try and keep things very kind of minimal, basic, straightforward. And I also just don't have a lot of time these days to do like the full kind of look. And to be honest, I'm actually really enjoying keeping things like super minimal. And this mascara is like one of my favorite mascaras ever. This is the Stila mascara, and I have had these for years. The bottle lasts me so long. I have not had to replenish this in at least a year and a half, I would say. This one right here, this is the Palladio Baked Blush. They are just like the high-end baked blushes out there. And I'm telling you, you don't need to spend a lot of money on those high-end ones because this one does the job. This is the Palladio Baked Blush. I think the shade is called Wish. And you guys, this shade right here is like a pink, but almost got like lavender tones in it, and it's got the perfect amount of glow. It's not glittery, but it is a little bit shimmery, but I love it so much because I love the tone. It's like a mid-tone, and I love how it gives me like this healthy glow. So just put some on my nose, a little bit on my chin, and there, boom, we are done. This is the look. I'm gonna try and give you better lighting so you guys can see what this looks like here. Okay, there, natural lighting. How's that? It's definitely a purple lipstick. I love purple. See the blush? Do you see a little bit of that glow? Yeah? It's pretty, right? So pretty. Anyway, that is the look. I'm gonna get to work here. And actually, I've got my straightener here that I wanted to just lightly go over my hair because it's looking just a little bit poofy. So anyway, this straightener that I'm using, I think it was gifted to me a while back. It's by Duval. It's lasted me a pretty long time, actually. My hair is at this like really awkward length right now, where it's not shoulder length, it's just like a little past my shoulder. So I feel like when I do blow dry, it gets really poofy. So I'm just kind of straightening it right now so it lays flat.
Please enter your PIN. Please leave your message for.
No worries, thank you. Hi to the books. And look, it was raining outside. Yeah, it was raining. Yeah, there's some raindrops. Yeah. Oh, you want to read a book? You want to read the Babies and Doggies book? I thought it'd be fun to share some outfit ideas for Easter, because Easter is literally right around the corner. And if you have like an Easter brunch to go to or like a family gathering, it'd be fun to just share some outfit ideas with you guys. And when I think about spring and Easter, I just think of florals and like fun pastel colors, like shades of light pink, yellows, blues. And I have a lot of that in my closet, and I'll try and leave links to everything on down below in the description box of this video. And I feel so like odd wearing these clothes because they're all like my pre-pregnancy clothes, and surprisingly I'm able to fit in some of them. But I have a lot of different outfit ideas that I want to share with you guys that I think are super fun for Easter. It's like a two-piece set, and I really love these shorts. They're really comfortable. It's got like a nice stretch to them, and they're not like super short. As you can see, they're actually fairly long. So this would be fun, I think, if you're going out to like a brunch or something. You can pair this with heels or wedges, like just a nice, quick, fun Easter daytime outfit that you can just like throw together with like a little crossbody, some pink heels, some white flats, and simple, easy. I love the pattern and the colors on this skirt. I just think it reminds me so much of spring. And I just love the color so much. And I figured this one would be really fun as well with like a green top, a blue top, or blue crop top. But I just did all white, kept it pretty basic, and I wanted the skirt to be kind of like the focal point. So that is kind of what that looks like. And again, you can wear heels, you can wear flats. A nice little blue bag crossbody would be super cute with this. Sticking with the same two-piece trend here, this is a simple, basic white denim skirt, but I've paired it with this kind of crop top tie over with like loose sleeves type of shirt. It's like light blue and it's got a really fun pattern. It's got nice florals everywhere. And I'm just wearing like a bralette kind of camisole, like underneath, like a crop top bralette thing. And this is fun because you can tie this in the front or you can tie it in the back if you wanted to. And it's like super lightweight, it's fun, flowy, and this is an outfit right here. You can pair it with a jacket if you wanted to, but because it's long sleeve, it keeps me warm enough. And the skirt is just basic white denim skirt, high heels with this, wedges, flats. I would probably just wear like some strappy flats and like a white handbag, and I would be good to go. So another really fun two-piece outfit for Easter. I love a good wrap skirt. This one is, I think, a size medium, but they are just so comfortable. There's really no zipper or anything. It's just like a button, and then you just tie it and wrap it. And I love this skirt because I love the length of it, and I really love the pattern. It's just very kind of Hawaiian, floral, and you can really kind of wear, like, you could do a white top if you want, but you can also play up on the dark blue. And you can also dress this one up or dress this one down, which I love. And it's just so comfortable. So I feel like this one would be also really fun for Easter too. I love a good knee-length dress, and it's got to be at the right length because I'm short. And if it goes too far down past my legs, it's going to cut me off and make me look even shorter. So this one is just the right length. This one I did buy on Amazon, and I love the color. I love the little peephole here. I love that it ties, and I'm obsessed with this dress. It is so easy, and it reminds me of spring. It reminds me of Easter. This is like a great, easy, simple outfit that you can throw a denim jacket on, a white jacket on, and call it a day. I love blue dresses as well, and I love pretty much all shades of blue, and this one is just like a really pretty kind of light blue dress, and I believe they have other colors as well, so I will leave a link to this down below. Sticking with the blue theme, this one has a really fun kind of floral print. This one I actually wore post-pregnancy because it is very, very forgiving. It's got that scrunchy kind of material here, so it doesn't like hug anywhere or like cinch your waist, although that would be kind of nice right now because it would give more of like an hourglass shape. You could wear like a tiny little belt. That'd be kind of cute, like a skinny belt just to kind of cinch it, but I just love this one too because it's blue. Yes, I love blue, and I love the floral print. I would wear this one with some wedges to give myself a little height because the length is a little bit awkward. I would like to see this dress like hemmed, maybe a little shorter. So I would wear some heels to kind of give myself some height and throw on a white denim jacket, and this would be such a cute Easter outfit. For some reason, I envisioned myself wearing like some really cute, like mid-calf cowboy boots with this dress. Maybe because of the colors, but I'm obsessed with this dress because of the colors and also because of the paisley print. It's this really kind of pretty muted green. It's not like in-your-face green. with some shades of like peach in there. So it's just a really fun dress. I love these ruffles here. I love the tie in the front and I love the shoulders so much. It's so comfortable, easy to throw on. It's a little stretchy and I think it's such an adorable dress for Easter and I love it. You throw on a little jacket, cardigan, a brown kind of crossbody or like a white bag would be kind of cute, like a white little handbag. Oh, I'm obsessed. I have so many other fun dresses to share with you guys, but maybe I'll do like a part two. I have some really fun dresses that I could share with you. So I will probably do maybe like a part two. If you guys are interested, let me know. Give this video a thumbs up. Got back from our Easter extravaganza and we had so much fun. He loved going on the train ride. He loved seeing the Easter bunny. We took a bunch of photos and he walked around and we were thinking it was gonna be that we wouldn't be able to attend because it was raining today, but it actually ended up being a success. They're looking fluffy. And we also picked up pizza for dinner. And I will show you. We went to Brooklyn City Pizzeria and Market. And look how massive this pizza is. It's 18 inches. And we got a pepperoni pizza for dinner. And then we got coupons to Crumble Cookies because we had attended that Easter event. And look, we got some cookies. So we're gonna get to trying these tonight. This one's a brookie, bit of confetti, oatmeal raisin, and chocolate chips. I'm excited to do a little taste test tonight. We went to the park after our little Easter event. And it is 3:45, so I'm gonna see if my son will go down for a nap. And that is what we've got going on right now. Mmm.
Very crisp.
I like the crust.
I feel like we might crisp it up even more.
But undercarriage? Super thin.
Dave only reviews cheese pizza.
Oh.
I guess that makes sense, but. I would review pepperoni, but.
Yeah. Probably so he keeps it universal across the board and like can just compare. All right, let's try these crumble cookies. We got chocolate chip, oatmeal raisin, confetti, and brookie. That's like a brownie and a cookie. That's good. It's soft.
You like took a bite, went on right in the down the middle.
I had to get both. Very good. Okay, I kind of want to try this confetti one. Ooh, confetti cookie. That's a lot of frosting. Ready? Wow. That frosting is really good, actually. Mmm. I'd probably give that one like a 7 out of 10. Brookie, I would give probably a 7.5 out of 10. Just because I like brookies more than like a sugar cookie with frosting. That's just my type of cookie. I prefer something like that as opposed to a lot of frosting. This is an oatmeal raisin. I'm not a huge oatmeal raisin fan. My husband loves oatmeal raisin. Wow, that's actually really good. I'm surprised. I'm serious. I don't even like raisins, but that's actually like really soft and like moist inside. And I love the cinnamon flavor. Okay. I think this is semi-sweet chocolate chip. That's a lot of chocolate chips on there. Here we go.
It's like a chunky chocolate chip.
Wow, that's a lot of chocolate. Okay, oatmeal raisin I would give like 6.5. Chocolate chip I would give...
Oh, you're gonna rate it better.
I'm just not a huge like oatmeal raisin fan, but I think you would like it.
Yeah.
The chocolate chip, I would probably give like a 6.
Really? Why is that?
It's just like the chocolate chunks are just, it's just too much. It's just like too much chocolate. Mm. And like, I want more of like the cookie dough.
Mm-hmm.
But I actually really like,
yeah.
Surprisingly, I like the frosting on this. It's really light. And like airy and like buttery.
I feel like that is your type of cookie.
That's good. It's just very, like a lot, it's a lot of frosting. It's like eating a cupcake. Which I love eating cupcakes, but I'm just not used to that much frosting on a cookie. Okay, another bite of the brookie and then I'm done for this evening. Mmm. Mmm. This is a good one. I like them. Okay. Brookie, like 7.5. Confetti, 7. Oatmeal raisin, 6.5. And then this one I would rate a 6. Do you remember my ratings now? I'm just curious to know what your ratings will be.
They're gonna be lower too.
Lower?
Yeah.
Or like Humble's lower. Yeah, we're not big crumble fans here. We just want like basic. We don't want anything fancy. But thank you to Crumble for these cookies. Or I should say thank you to the event for giving us coupons to these cookies. Mmm, super good. I'm stuffed now. That was a major, major cheat meal. It is now a lot later in the evening and I'm ready to call it. I am beat. I am stuffed. We went for a little walk to kind of digest all of our food and I just needed some time to like digest everything because I ate so much pizza and so many cookies. I mean, I didn't like finish any one particular cookie, but I just took so many bites of all of them that I'm just like, feel like my skin has improved so much since just changing up my diet and just like taking care of it. And I've been using like more sunscreen and let me actually show you what I've been wearing at nighttime. It's like a retinol product that I got from a facialist. It's called Alpharet's Clearing Serum by Skin Better Science. This has also really helped with just like my skin texture and with like the size of my pores. But anyway, it is time to take off this makeup and head to bed. So thank you guys so much for watching this vlog. If you guys like these types of videos, thumbs up this video. Let me know down in the comments what other types of videos you would like to see. It would really help me out. I appreciate your support. I will see you in my next one. Bye. Yeah.